Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what is corrosion and how the corrosion is occurring on the iron, and we have also studied the mechanism, and we have also learned that this corrosion leads to a massive destruction of not only the metal but also the economy as well as the environment. So let us now study how can we protect the corrosion of a particular metal. So let us see. One of the few methods to protect the corrosion of a metal is, the common method is to coat a metal surface by a paint. In this thing, what happens is, if we paint a particular metal, then what we are going to do is we are preventing it a direct contact of oxygen or moisture with the particular metal. In this case, as we did in corrosion mechanism also, that the oxygen and the moisture, they play a very vital role in the destruction of a metal. So to avoid this thing, what we are doing is we are painting painting a particular metal so as there should be no contact of oxygen and water with the metal. But sometimes what happens, if we paint a car or we paint a particular instrument, or if we paint a particular block of a metal, then sometimes even though a scratch will be produced, then the rusting will start from the inner layer itself. That is, we could see that there would be a bump, or there would be air gap, and there would be bubble formation between the metal surface and the paint. So this will create a possibility that the rusting process is still going on, and we have to apply the paint again, or we have to do some other treatment so as to protect the particular metal. So painting is one of the most cheapest and one of the most common method that we are applying so as to prevent the corrosion. So this is the most cheapest thing, and I hope you have got to know that how a metal can be protected with the help of the paint. Talking about the next thing is passivation. What is passivation actually? The treatment of a metal by a strong oxidizing acid like nitric acid, like HNO3, to form a thin preventive layer of oxide on the metal surface is known as passivation. Again, let me tell you about this thing is, we are now, when we are protecting through passivation, when we are protecting it by formation of an oxide layer. In this thing, we are purposely making the metal to be attacked by the nitric acid. So by purposely reacting it with a oxidizing acid like HNO3, we are forming a particular oxide layer, and that oxide layer will be inactive in the sense it won't allow the air or the moisture present in the air to enter through that oxide layer. So even though a layer is been formed, the inner layer, that is the inner metal, will be protected from this kind of components like air and water that would affect the corrosion, or that would increase the corrosion of a particular material. So this process, by reacting it with a strong oxidizing agent or strong oxidizing acid, is known as passivation. So this is how can we protect. Now talking about the next thing is alloy formation. As you know, what is alloy? Alloy is the mixture of a metal and a metal, or a metal and a non-metal. So it means the process of mixing a metal or a non-metal in a metal to form a homogeneous mixture is known as alloying. So the most common thing is, we know that iron is a pure element in which the rusting takes place, and we have did the mechanism also that how the rusting takes place. So when we talk about steel, or when we talk about stainless steel, so stainless steel is made up of iron as well as carbon as well as various other metals and non-metals. So what happens actually in that case is, the iron is being changed into a something different kind of a compound that is known as stainless steel in this case. So in this case, what happens is, when we are preparing stainless steel, so stainless steel is an alloy of Fe and chromium and much more elements also. So in this case, what happens if, even though if a rusting takes place, then the chromium will form an oxide that will form a very protective layer on the iron, and hence this stainless steel can be prevented from, or this iron can now be prevented from the corrosion in the form of stainless steel, and hence the particular iron can be protected by using or by the formation of an alloy. So this is how can we protect the iron. And the next step is galvanization. What is galvanization actually? Let us see. Preventing a metal from corrosion by coating another metal that will oxidize is known as galvanization. In galvanization, actually, we commonly use zinc. So what actually happens is this, that we are dipping the main object. Suppose if I want to protect a particular some object like iron block. So what I'm going to do is I will dip in a solution of a melted or a molten zinc, so that after cooling, the zinc layer will be formed on the surface of the iron. And in this case, the zinc will oxidize and the iron will get reduced, or it will get protected. How? See, if we know that the reduction potential of the iron is -0.44 volt, but that of the reduction potential of zinc is -0.763 volt, and as we did earlier, the lesser the reduction potential of a particular element, the more it will be acting like a anode. And the more it will act like a anode, then in this case Fe will be acting like a cathode, and as we know that anode goes on the oxidation process and it will be converted into an aqueous form. A particular element, suppose if zinc is undergoing oxidation process, then zinc will form Zn2+ by liberating 2 electrons, and this 2 electrons will be very helpful for the iron, so as to deposit more iron on it. So in this case, the iron is being turning into a cathode while the zinc is being turning into an anode. So in this process, we could protect a particular metal, and especially in this case, we can protect iron. So this process is known as galvanization of a particular material, in this case for iron. Was very much simple. Now talking about the next topic, that is the last one, is cathodic protection. It is similar to that of the galvanization, but the thing is, we are not coating it with or we are not dipping the iron in zinc. In this case, we are connecting the two metals, in which one would be acting like an anode, while the one which we have to protect will act like a cathode. So let us see the definition of it. So the metal to be protected is made to be cathode purposely by connecting more active metal that acts as anode. Suppose the let me give you an example. The underground pipes, the water pipes which are present under the ground, they have also the possibility to get rusted, or they have also the possibility to get corroded, because they the soil in through which they pass has can have moisture, and that moisture can lead to corrosion of that particular pipe and iron pipe, and that would be affecting for us to drink those corroded water. So what to do? The thing is, we are connecting it with a particular through wire, we are connecting it to a particular element which gets oxidized or which act as anode. So if that wire, or if that component is acting as an anode, and if it is connected to a iron, so the one which is acting as an anode, it will show oxidation, while the iron will be showing the process of reduction, because it will show the process like cathode. It will show a process which occurs at cathode. So basically, we are converting the iron into cathode while the other one is acting like an anode. Let me give an example. The same example that we have I have given earlier, that is the reduction potential of iron is -0.44 volt. Suppose if that iron block, or if that iron pipe is connected to the magnesium block, that is which has an reduction potential of -2.37 volt, this means the magnesium will try to lose electron or try to oxidize first and will protect the iron. So in this process, even though the iron, that is even though it will it corrodes into Fe2+, or if it gets oxidized, suppose in any case if it oxidizes to Fe2+, then what will happen is immediately this magnesium will get oxidized, and those two electrons that will be liberated from the magnesium will go towards the iron Fe2+, and that Fe2+ will again be converted into Fe. So in this case, again the iron is being protected, and hence by using this thing, cathodic protection, we could protect the particular iron. So these were the few examples from how we could protect a particular metal from corrosion, and we could stop the destruction of a metal. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got understood that what are the different methods to protect a particular metal. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.